everyone, summer parties are right around the corner, and who doesn't love a party with the perfect photo op? This one over here loves them. So Maria is here with an easy-peasy lemon squeezy photo op for your summer soiree. Oh, and I do mean lemon squeezy,
exactly.
Right, Maria?
Exactly. I mean, lemons are so beautiful, and I wanted to do an artistic take on that because I just love a good photo op at any party, and this is a really great and simple DIY that you can do for all of your summer parties.
Well, we all got in front of it and started taking pictures.
Oh, yes, we did.
Today because
we did.
It's so much fun. Mm-hmm. Look at that. There's you and Ken. Aw.
And then yeah. Oh, wow. Ken went crazy and started jumping.
Oh, my goodness. It really brought out the child in Ken, didn't it? And then, of course, I feel like
I could call
this one pink lemonade.
Aw.
Right? You see that? That's so cute. Anyway, people are fighting to get pictures in front of this, so as soon as we're done here, trust me, they will be lined
up. Yes, and you can see how perfect. It is four
and it's
pictures.
It's really easy to make, actually.
It's very simple. So you start out, the base of this are actually these fans. These are like little paper fans.
Okay.
And you get these at a craft supply store or a party store. You can get them online. They come either as paper or tissue paper. So this is where you see how it's kind of like intricate. This is going to be a little bit more detailed and kind of like feminine and frilly. These are a little bit more structured.
What are these really used for?
They're just to hang. Just for decorations, simply for decorations.
Cool.
Yeah, so, but I'm going to show you what you can do to create the rind along the outside of the lemon because that's kind of really what sells it as it being a
right,
lemon.
Exactly.
So what I did was I took, this is just poster board that I have it on, and so all of these are extremely inexpensive. So you take yours, and what you would do, what I did for mine, I did it kind of just like in a very like easy way, an imperfect way, is I did a circle along the outside, and I cut it out. And I have one cut here. I cut it out, and then I just kind of trimmed it accordingly, and I used that as my template for all the other ones that were the same size.
Okay.
And I just folded it in half to cut out the center. You see it looks like a little smiley face.
Nice.
I cut it out, and what you want to do is you want to make sure to place it on. If it's too short, you can always trim the outside, or, you know, that's what, all of these are paper or tissue, and that's where you get your look. You can see this on here.
That is so cute.
And to create the actual, like, detail on this, what I did, Deb, I took it outside and grabbed a can of spray paint, and all I did was spray along the outside, leaving the inside just white. You could spray if you have yellow, or yellow paper, you could spray the inside
white.
Right. So you do the
opposite. Could you use like a sponge if you didn't have spray paint and just use?
Oh yeah, you definitely could. I do like using the spray paint because it does create a really pretty ombre effect.
Oh, right.
But you definitely could if spray paint kind of like isn't in your wheelhouse, you could definitely use that.
No, but you're right because the fallout from the spray really
does
make it look authentic with the lemon rind.
And I'm just attaching it with a hot glue gun,
easy.
And that's all it really is. And you would do the same thing with the tissue as well.
Now, if you left it like that, it would be nice, but you made it look even more authentic by adding seeds.
I did. So I came up with a really good idea for the seeds because the idea of cutting seed after seed seemed very tedious to me and not efficient.
No.
So what I thought of, this is the heart punch. We've used this a number of times on the show, and this is one of Debbie's favorite crafts.
I love this. So, I love anything that you can punch out.
Have at it, sister. So if you can do a couple of those for me. So what I did here, I took the heart punch and I cut it out because look at, after you do that, so you pop it in here, I'll show
Where's
you right
going?
Here. Right, just like this.
Oh, like that, backwards. Okay.
There we go. And
Thank
so
you.
All I did was Ooh. Cut it in half, and after you do that, you can just kind of take your scissors and create a little bit of like that. And that's how you do your seed on there. And you can just do this over and over and over again. Perfect.
So you make them that way they're
exactly. So yep, and just cut it down the middle, and you can just kind of like take your scissors and make the, and if you wanted them to be smaller, for instance, you could do this and make them a little smaller, or you could just do this and take that sort of edge off, and you have your seeds done, and they go on with the glue gun as well.
And they're perfectly symmetrical that
way. They're perfectly symmetrical, and that's, I think, what sells it, too, as the lemon, and you can just line them up. And you could do more seeds if you want, but I think you only really need, I like doing this because then it kind of makes it look like they're the inside as well, and that's all you really
that.
Need to
yeah,
do.
Can we, let's do four on that one. Can we
do
four?
Do
we only
four?
Did three on the rest. No, I don't want to mess it up. Let's keep it at three. Keep it the same.
There we go.
So those are adorable. We have our lemons done. Now we need our leaves.
Okay, so for the leaves, I love the element of the leaves in there. I love the green that's added in. And so these are just foam sheets. Again, craft supply store, really inexpensive. And what I did, I folded this in half, and cut it from basically edge to edge, and that's what I have here. And Deb, to create a really cool sort of detailed look on here, what I do is I score it. I take a pair of scissors that are closed. If you don't have a scoring tool, this is the best way to do it. And you do your line like that, and you can add some details into
the... So you see it. Oh, that's
Yeah, but it's very subtle, you know? So you have that, and like, it's a nice little detail that you can see that just goes onto the wall as well with everything.
You could do this with green construction paper.
Yes. And you wouldn't get the details of the scoring, but you could get the same type of thing with, even if you painted it or
That's
something.
What I was going to say. Go back with a black marker and put them in there, or a brown marker.
Yes.
Now we have all of our elements, but now you have to actually do the layout. How
did
you do that?
This is the really fun part. Yes.
It could get tricky here.
It can get tricky. So a couple thoughts on this is when you're setting it up, start with your focal point where you want your center to be and kind of go out from there. So what I decided to do is I decided to space out my larger ones so that I could really have those in the space instead of going like big in the center and having it go small on the way out. So once you have your big ones up, you can kind of do the fill with the medium and the small. And as you can see, they're all kind of layered in there to have that like dimensional aspect. And then go in and kind of like fluff, if you will, with the leaves. You have the small leaves, the different color leaves, and you have them with the detail.
The different
going
textures.
In. Exactly, different textures of the paper and then the tissue paper. All of those add such a great, there's so much, it looks very simple and really nice to the eye, but there's a lot of detail that goes into creating that really cool backdrop.
And then you just hung them with some...
Oh, mounting tape.
Mounting tape,
and depending on your wall, you could potentially do it with like a tack. Depending on what you're using, that'd be better for the paper ones, not necessarily the tissue. But mounting tape worked for us. That's what we did today.
Maria, the only thing left to do is to have a party and take a picture.
There you go.
All right, I guess we'll take the picture first, and then we'll throw the party after.
Cheese.
Make sure you guys visit HallmarkChannel.com for full instructions on how to make this really cool photo op. So.
Later on Home and Family, we're dishing up mouth-watering barbecue tacos.
This is some real Tex-Mex.
So good.
And how to be a great mom while still pursuing your own dreams.
We can't do it all and do it all well.